Hello everyone and welcome to the Extreme TIG channel. So for today's video guys, I'm gonna prep a 4-inch SCAD 80 pipe. I'm gonna clean it in and out. We're gonna set up gap 4 mil. You don't want to go too wide. So the idea of this video today is to show you x-ray quality 6G procedure, how to achieve successful pass x-ray, VT, bend test. So I try to keep really tight 1/8. As long as I can fit that 1/8 inside, I try to keep a consistent gap all the way around up to 4 mil. The crucial thing about pipe is prep, pretty much, to have nice good setup, consistent gap. You have to make sure your bevel is straight, your pipe is straight, it's not wobbly. There is one spot on the pipe, it's a little bit too wide, it's like loose 532. I'm gonna stack a wedge inside just to keep that gap so it doesn't shrink on me when I put tacks. I'm gonna use a bridge rod and put 3 tacks. I'm gonna start on the bottom and now we're gonna position in a 6G. Okay, this is a 6G, 45 degree. Okay, so I'm gonna give you a little tip with a nozzle. You know how with a nozzle usually always got that contamination on the edge of the nozzle. It's a little bit hard to walk that cup if you're sliding or if you're freehand. But this is a little tip. If you round that edge, I like to use a flapper disc. So when it's nice and round, it's smooth. You can really place nice, good, smooth root. It's gonna be nice and uniform. If you prefer to walk the cup on the root, this is definitely gonna help you. As I said, really slide nice. And 1/8 tungsten as usual, 2% lanthanated. And pretty much you want to start from the top, fitting. It's like a back feed, guys. 126 amps I'm gonna use on that root. It's a 1/8 rod. And this is one of the idea with that round edge of the nozzle. It's really nice and easy to manipulate, especially if you like to walk the cup on the root. So one of the reasons why I like to walk the cup is I always have that nice, consistent and uniform root. So the whole idea with especially with the 6G, you want to pass that VT initially, and then you're gonna pass an x-ray or bend test, it doesn't matter. The whole idea is kind of back feed, make sure you have lots of meat, it's uniform, it's a consistent, as you can see that I'm manipulating here with my torch. I'll go from 6 to 8 o'clock and then I'm gonna stop, and that's where I'm gonna take that tack out. The whole idea is you should have only one stop on your route. Then you go close to that bridge tack, take it out and continue on. And pretty much I'm gonna go all the way close to the 12 o'clock or to the top. Just maintain that rod inside a puddle, stretch that puddle. Just watch your travel speed, adjust your amperage. As I said, I'm 126. You could go lower, especially on the top portion of the pipe. You can even lower down amps. You can go 110, just to prevent that gravity so it doesn't sag in. And this is the whole idea of the root, to have nice, consistent, uniform root. You should have last minimum or maximum one stop, and that's around bridge tacks or root tacks, whatever procedure is. I like to use a bridge tack. I don't wanna, that's what makes my root even more uniform, especially if you struggle with the tie-ins, and then it's gonna be visible. So that's only one of the reasons why I really prefer bridge tacks, so you hardly see any tines, like for the, if you had a root tax, it's pretty much gonna be visible. Okay, this is the one side, so half of the pipe is done. As I said, I like to backfeed the bottom part and just kind of keep it slightly inside that edge and all the way to the top. Now I'm gonna do the other side. Same idea as I'm showing you here. Just keep it on the top, inside that edge of that bevel. You see how far I'm going from that surface of that pipe? It's almost 532. As I said, as you guys know, especially the you guys that are following me for a longer time, you know I like to have a little bit heavier root. It's just a habit. Unless the procedure says different, then you gotta follow the specs on the procedure. But it's as I said, it's just a habit, especially preventing any sagbacks, as I like to run hot on my really hot on my hot pass, minimum 160 up to 180. It all depends. That's where I started on a little bit wider section that was on the root. I placed that on the bottom part, as you don't want to have that on the top. On the top you want to have a little bit tight, but the whole idea when you also you want to maintain that gap when you initially tag this pool, you want to maintain that the same gap. So ideally is put your bridge tacks or root tacks minimum half inch, and that's what's gonna keep your gap even. Once you're close to the top, you can slightly pull out that rod and keep it in on the edge of that puddle. You can pull it out, you don't have to hold it in inside that edge of the bevel, inside the root. And you gotta control your puddle. That's the whole idea. Now I'm doing final tie-in on my root on the top. I always like to pause a little bit and then just go over half inch, and that's it pretty much for the root. This is the whole root. As you can see yourself, there's not much stops, as I only stop one side, one time on each side, just to get rid of my bridge tacks, and you can only see that pretty much the tie-in on the top. I'll pause a little bit too much. Now I'm going for hot pass. Hot pass is going to be 160, and I'm just going to fast forward here. It's a fill to flush. Now I'm going to start with the two pass cap. This is going to be one side. It doesn't really matter which side. You can go and start on the bottom side and finish the last pass on the top portion. Same amperage, 160, same rod, same size. Let's say I like cup 12 for capping, especially can handle that heat. I got good argon coverage. Make sure you clean each pass, buffing wheel, grinder, whatever works for you better. You want to get rid of any obstacles outside or inside that bevel on the surface of the pipe. Make it nice and clean, so your each pass is going to be really nice and clean. On my cup 12, I got around 15 liters of argon flow going through my torch. And now I'm going to put a second pass. And that's the final pass. It's gonna be two pass cap, as I said. And that's it, guys. Just little idea, a little practice. Maintain that the walk, the steps you got. Try to make nice consistent, same as your route. do the same thing with a cap and you should be golden. As I said, guys, try to do that if you want to have nice, good, solid root, minimum stops. Try to have one stop on each side and it's going to be nice and uniform, consistent root. Same as a cap, nice and uniform, same idea. If you can do one side without stop and then finish on the other side, then you're going to have nice, good, consistent cap as well. And that's it, pretty much. Hope you guys like it. Like, share, subscribe, and don't forget to hit that bell button as well. And see you in the next one, guys. Take care.